Packard update. As you can see, the Packard's in first stage primer, getting body work or epoxy sealer, that is probably epoxy sealer, getting its body work started. Get too close to it, you can't see what you're looking at. And he's working on it. He says he's still got to work out these mechanisms for this back window before he does any cutting on it. And he's second guessing that. And he pulled the Packard engine out of it. And that's not going in the Packard now. He's going to go with this AMC. This nice little AMC engine is going to go in that Packard. And then out here, we've got the Mercury. Her paint job is done. Kitty's been all over. It's getting dirty. This is a nice car. This is my best friend Rod's car. And it's a 51. 53. It's a 53 Mercury convertible. It's really nice. My favorite is the 56 Mercury Montclair with the lightning bolt down the side. There's my old Bronco. And so we're out here. We're going to put that starter on it and see what we get. All right. It's F100. Old 50-something F100. I don't know what exactly year model it is. But building a hot rod. Check this out. This is a Jaguar. Jaguar rear end. And you see it's a dual coil over. It's got dual coilovers. And if you look at it here, it's got what they call inboard brakes. So the brakes are next to the pumpkin instead of out here on your wheel. And look how much room that frees up for meats. That tire is probably a 15, probably 7-inch tire. Maybe, yeah, 7-inch wide. So you could probably go up to a 10. Look how much room you have for meats in this thing. It's pretty cool. A Jaguar rear end and something like that. There's a little bit of engineering. But a lot of your hot rods will have this type of rear end, that Jaguar rear end with those inboard brakes. It's a really cool, it's a really good rear end. That's where the old starter was. It wasn't working. And the way I figured it is, I think this engine is out of a 57 pickup truck. And that starter was out of a 59. So I've got another starter, and let's see if that starter works. So I'm going to put that on. Okay, putting the bottom bolt in now. As you can see, she's going in there pretty good. This starter feels like the right starter because it bolted up really a lot easier than the other starter did. There's a lot more room in here to work with than there was on the other starter. So we'll see. Find my tools. Oh, my hand in the way there. There we go. Now I'm gonna change this socket out. Take the extension off of that. And see if I can get it. Excuse the cameras. Oh, there we go. See, my flywheel doesn't look. Yeah, my flywheel doesn't look too bad. I took the cover off of it. All right, let's see if we can tighten it up. And I hope I was recording that whole time. All right, starter bolt is in. Man, I hope I didn't. I hope we recorded all that. So, all right, let's go back up top and tighten up the top bolt and hook up the wires. Okay, here we are. Looking down on that top bolt of that starter. See it right there? Come in here with my wrench and just tighten it on up. Because you want it good and tight. tough spot, so this is about the only way I can get into it. So coming. Get tighter. More turns, she'll be there. There she is. That's tight. One more. Starter's on. That's the new starter. Or new rebuilt starter. It's a little smaller than the other starter that was on here, which leads me to believe that that starter was from a 59. And this starter's for a 57. So let's see if it'll start. Get the hot water hooked up. Which runs back to the solenoid, which runs to the battery, and now I'm going to use jumpers to make it turn over. Okay, I've got a jumper from the hot wire that will go to the coil on the hot side. Okay, coil hot side. This jumper right here will hook to that coil, and then this jumper that I have from the solenoid put on the hot cable of the battery, and that will engage the starter. Now, I don't want to burn up the coil, so I do not want to burn up the coil, so I don't want it to hook, I don't want it to, until I'm ready to go. So let's go ahead and hook everything up, hot, engage my ground, all the way down, the battery's hot. Oh, 3, 2, 1, come on guys. Let's just see if this thing will turn over. Please turn over. Fine. She's fine. She's fine. We have no problems here. No, we can go on with this build. Thank you. I'm glad I don't have to do a 318. She's fine. She's fine. Stay tuned. We got her turning over. Now let's see if we can get her running. Okay, so it all worked out. We got it all figured out. We being me. So what happened was when I bought this car, when I got this car, it had an engine in it from a 1957. A 1957 D100 Dodge pickup truck. The starter gave me grief, so I took the starter, I had it rebuilt. I put it back in, same thing, jamming up. Nothing happening good. So I did a lot of research on that starter, and I found out that starter was from a 1959 Dodge D100. So I got to looking and looking, and there was a difference between the 57 and 59, and 59 on the 70s, it was a different starter. So I looked around the internet, and on eBay, I found a guy with a 57 starter off a Cornette. I'm like, well, let me take a shot. So I went ahead and bought it. And the idea was, if this didn't fix it, because the reason behind that thinking, you need to know the reason behind that thinking. The reason I was thinking going the 318 route or the, you know, the 340 route was if the starter was jamming up because that rear main was out. You know, so the next thing I would do if I would continue on this engine is I'd pull that transmission, check to see if that rear main was out, and if it was wobbling around in the housing into the block, making it jam. So that was my worry, and I'm like, well, it'd just be easier to buy a modern engine, throw in there, and get on down the road. Don't have to do that. I put that starter in it. That starter is for 57. It bolted up good. It did everything it was supposed to do going in, real easy. No hard like the other one was really hard to get in there. Didn't have any room for wrenches or anything. This one bolted right up, took me 5 minutes, put it in, turns over like a top. And I'm very happy because this little inline six is going to be a pretty, pretty engine. It's going to be really nice when it gets done. It's not going to be a race car, but it's going to be a nice classic restoration. So stick with me, we'll get it fired up. I got to talk to Rick, see if I can find gallons of gas.